So while the sleeve may be the right option for most of our patients, about 60% of patients who get bariatric surgery in our practice, as well as the rest of the country, are getting the sleeve gastrectomy these days. The sleeve gastrectomy can, one of the issues is just some patients end up getting reflux after a sleeve gastrectomy. And so if you already have reflux, significant reflux prior to bariatric surgery, then oftentimes you're steered more towards this option, which tends to get rid of reflux, a gastric bypass. It also tends to be a little bit better for diabetes. Now, this is an operation that's been around since the 1960s and has passed the test of time and has stuck around as a very effective option. Surgery takes us about an hour and a half, 2 hours. Most patients spend one or two nights in the hospital, same recovery outside the hospital and similar weight loss to the sleeve, slightly a little bit more weight loss, is 65 to 70% excess weight loss with a bypass. You know, similar, if somebody is 100 pounds overweight, roughly 60 to 70 pound weight loss one can expect. Again, this is done through this very similar incisions to what we do with a sleeve gastrectomy. And in this operation, what's done is we divide the stomach into two portions, a small portion here, and then this bigger portion. And then we bring up a piece of intestine and connect it to the small stomach here. So that when you eat, the food goes from the esophagus directly into the small stomach and directly into the intestines. And it bypasses this portion of the stomach and some portion of the intestines. Now, this works with weight loss and helping with the diabetes in two ways. Number one, because the stomach is smaller, you can't eat as much. Number two, the change in the anatomy also leads to a change in hormones, some of which impact your hunger, and some of which also targets your diabetes a bit better. Also, because of the by changing the direction of the anatomy, all of the acid from this bypassed stomach and now and the bile that's in the intestine over here, it's no longer coming up to the esophagus the way it was before. It's being directed further down into the intestines so that if somebody had reflux, that's how the reflux ends up getting better.
You know, I would say that in all the years I've been doing this, gastric bypass has passed the test of time, as Abe said. But nobody likes the idea of having their intestines rerouted. The reason to go for a more complex operation like this is a patient who has bad reflux, because this operation will get rid of reflux, and patients with significant diabetes, because a gastric bypass is twice as effective as a sleeve at getting rid of diabetes, putting it into remission, literally having normal sugars off medications in up to 90% of patients, depending how severe the diabetes is. And we talk about that on an individual basis, the prediction. The worse the diabetes, the more aggressive the operation maybe needs to get rid of it. You might only have a 30% chance of getting rid of diabetes with a sleeve and a 75% chance of getting rid of it with a bypass. The second thing is people think I'm not going to be able to eat. I'm going to have diarrhea. And we really don't see that. People can eat most foods. Obviously, we encourage you to stay away from sweets, and that can lead to some side effects. But you can eat most foods. There's not diarrhea, and there's very little in the way of significant problems that comes from this rearrangement, other than some difficulty absorbing certain vitamins and minerals, which can be easily replaced by pills.
And so, you know, the picture may look more complex than the other one, and it is. The other one's certainly simpler, but in the terms of safety, they're both very safe. And for the most part, in terms of the main risks, I would say it has similar risks to that of the sleeve.
Yeah, I would say too that having either of these operations is less risk than having a knee replacement. It's less risk than having your gallbladder out for infected gallbladder. And so these operations have become really, really safe compared to what they were 20 years ago when I started doing this, when the risks were 10 times higher than they are now. In large part because we're doing laparoscopy and small incisions, but also we've just gotten so much better at recognizing problems and taking care of them early.